One of the things we need to be aware of with the aftermarket engine management industry is keeping up with the latest changes that the OEs are bringing in with the latest production cars. Technology here is always changing, and one of the aspects that we wanted to focus on here is the technology used to send signal data between the sensor and the ECU itself. Now, there can be some problems with this sensor data, particularly in terms of susceptibility to noise and even aspects such as voltage drops and voltage offsets. And when we've got these sort of problems, it means that the information the ECU is receiving might not be exactly what the sensor is sending out. Obviously, in order for the ECU to be able to do its job properly, it's essential for the integrity of this information to be rock solid. A new technology that we are seeing emerge now in the OE world is where the sensor information is converted from analog to digital at the sensor and then sent to the ECU as a digital signal. There are two competing techniques here. There is SENT, which stands for Single Edge Nibble Transmission, and PSI5, which is a Bosch protocol. At the moment, there is a bit of a battle between these two protocols, but SENT does seem to be the one that is leading the charge. This technology uses a built-in microprocessor within the sensor that takes that analog signal, turns it into a digital signal, and then transmits it to the ECU. Now, using this technology does provide a little bit more flexibility to the manufacturer as well. So if we take, for example, a drive-by-wire throttle body, conventionally, this requires two signals that tell the ECU about the throttle plate angle, and this is used for safety. If the two signals don't stack up, the ECU knows something's wrong and can take the appropriate action. Now, if we look at how SENT can be used to integrate these signals, for the likes of the GM C7 Corvette drive-by-wire throttle body, this uses SENT technology. However, the two signals are transmitted independently via SENT. On the other hand, if we look at a late model throttle body from the latest Ford EcoBoost engines, then the drive-by-wire throttle body actually does the internal validation of the two signals, and the position is sent out as a single signal. And there's also some validation data that is transmitted via SENT to the ECU so that the ECU knows if there are any problems with the throttle angle and the drive-by-wire throttle operation. For us in the aftermarket, we always need to be watching what the OEs are doing because, of course, this technology does trickle down, and at some point, we're also going to need to adopt it and use it.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.